Charles Darwin's journey as a naturalist and the father of evolutionary theory is one of both scientific discovery and deep personal transformation. Born on February 12, 1809, in Shrewsbury, England, Darwin was raised in a family that emphasized both education and independent thought. His grandfather, Erasmus Darwin, was a renowned physician, poet, and a proto-evolutionary thinker who speculated on the transmutation of species. This intellectual lineage set the stage for Darwin's interest in the natural world. Although his early life suggested he might take a different path, in his youth, Darwin initially pursued studies in medicine at the University of Edinburgh. Following in the footsteps of his father, Robert Darwin, who was also a physician. However, Darwin quickly discovered he had little interest in the medical field, finding the procedures grueling and the sight of blood intolerable. His aversion to medicine keened him to abandon his studies there and later shift to Cambridge University, with plans to become an Anglican clergyman. Cambridge introduced him to influential figures in the scientific community, most notably John Stevens Hensler, a botanist who encouraged Darwin's passion for natural history and field work. Through Henslow, Darwin was recommended for the journey that would change his life and the scientific world, a voyage on HMS Beagle. In 1831, at the age of 22, Darwin joined Captain Robert Fitzroy on a five-year expedition around the world. Darwin's role was to study the geological features and collect specimens of flora and fauna across the South American coast and the surrounding islands. His time in the Galapagos Islands became crucial in forming his theories on evolution. Observing species such as finches, Darwin noted that they varied significantly from island to island, with each species adapting uniquely to its specific environment. These finches exhibited slight differences in beak shape, which Darwin hypothesized were adaptations to different food sources. Such observations planted the seeds of what would become his groundbreaking theory, that species were not static, immutable forms, but were capable of change and adaptation over time. After returning to England in 1836, Darwin spent the next decades meticulously documenting his findings, collecting more evidence, and analyzing various forms of life. He observed similarities between species in geographically separated locations, leading him to conclude that species evolved gradually, diverging over generations to adapt to their environments. This understanding was revolutionary. Until then, the predominant belief, particularly in Western society, was that species were divinely created in their current forms. Influenced by the works of Thomas Malthus on population growth and competition for resources, Darwin developed the concept of natural selection, proposing that species with advantageous traits were more likely to survive and reproduce, passing on these beneficial traits to subsequent generations. In 1859, Darwin published On the Origin of Species, his seminal work detailing his theories on evolution and natural selection. This publication was met with widespread controversy and intrigue. In Victorian England, the book's challenge to the traditional views of creation and its implications for humanity's place in the natural world stirred public debate and resistance, especially from religious institutions. However, the scientific community recognized the thoroughness of Darwin's research, and his ideas quickly gained traction among naturalists and thinkers. Darwin's theories on evolution were radical not only in content, but also in their methodical approach, presenting a model based on empirical evidence rather than philosophical speculation or religious doctrine. Darwin's later life was marked by declining health, possibly exacerbated by his years of strenuous fieldwork and mental exertion. Despite his health issues, he continued to publish books and treatises that explored various aspects of natural history and evolution, including The Descent of Man in 1871, where he applied his theories to human evolution, suggesting that humans shared a common ancestor with other primates. This extension of his theory into the realm of human origins intensified the public and academic debate surrounding evolution, further challenging long-held religious and societal beliefs. the implications of Darwin's theories extended beyond biology, influencing fields as diverse as anthropology, psychology, and sociology. Darwin's work became a foundation for modern science, emphasizing observation, experimentation, and hypothesis as central to understanding natural phenomena. By the time of Darwin's death on April 19, 1882, his theories had profoundly influenced scientific thought. Though he encountered significant opposition, his work had ignited a paradigm shift, fostering a greater understanding of the diversity of life on Earth. Darwin's legacy endures through the continued study and application of evolutionary biology, affirming his place as one of history's most influential scientists. His journey from a young, uncertain student to the father of evolutionary theory reflects not only a personal transformation, but a reshaping of how humanity perceives life's complexity and interconnectedness.